view just doesn't suck. You can almost see my house from here. Anyways, I'm Daniel Sapp, tech editor at Pink Bike. Today, we're checking out the new Transition Scout. It's the latest edition. The Scout is all carbon and 140 millimeters of travel in the back, 150 up front. And there have been a few other major changes. Let's go through those and check it out. Originally, the Scout was launched in alloy and then in carbon with that same model, along with the Patrol and the Smuggler. That first Scout had 125 millimeters of travel out in the back and 140 up front. This new one bumps up to 140 in the rear and 150 up front in an all carbon frame. As far as numbers go, reach of 460 millimeters, this is on a size medium, head tube angle is 64 degrees, 430 mil chainstays, and the stock shock is a 205 by 57 and a half. Why do I mention that? Well, you can run a different shock on there and actually get more than 140 millimeters of travel. You can put a 205 by 62 and a half and get 150, and you can leave the fork at 150 or put a 160 on it, whatever. The new shock has 24.5% progression. It's linearly progressive the whole way. You can also run coil shocks with no issue. Air shocks, they come with one spacer. Says so on the frame. Sweet spot is 28 to 30% sag, but you can really run anywhere from 25 to 35% sag, depending on how high you want to ride in the travel. I've played around with this a lot and it's accurate. I've settled on about 28% myself. There's internal cable routing for the rear derailleur dropper cable. The rear brake cable is not internal. The idea behind that is serviceability. And you know, if you're out riding and happen to smash into a tree and break your brake lever, you can easily swap another brake on there without having to do a full bleed. And you can run a full chain guide on it. You've got full ISCG05 tabs. So there's recessed frame protection on the down tube, chain stay and seat stay. And that's designed to quiet the chain down as much as anything else. And the bike does ride really quietly. All the bearings are Enduromax. The main pivot and the rocker pivot bearings both have shields and covers in order to keep water and dirt out. So when you're over at the car wash, pressure washing your bike, which you probably shouldn't do anyways, but let's be real, you do it, you don't get a lot of water up in there and kill your bearings. On the underside of the top tube, there's an accessory tool mount. So you can mount tools there. Like for example, the new Wolf Tooth tool goes right there. There's also a lot of standover and a pretty long seat tube insertion, so there's a lot of clearance. You can run a really long dropper post. The rear brake, 180 mil post mount only. So there's several different build kit options for the new Scout. The one you're looking at here is the GX level build. Comes with a RockShox Super Deluxe Ultimate, a RockShox Lyric Ultimate, GX drivetrain, Sensus grips, 1UP seat post, and SRAM Code RSC brakes. That bike sells for $5,499. And there you have it. That's the new Transition Scout. What do you think? You gonna go free riding? Let us know in the comments below.